Now, if you look at the memory footprint of a process and the amount of time it takes to load all of its working set into the cache, the bigger the memory footprint, the more time it's going to take for the processor to get the working set of a particular thread into the cache so that the cache is warm enough and the process or the thread can do its work without having to have those hiccups where it has to go to the memory in order to fetch the contents into the cache. So what this suggests is that it's important to pay attention to cache affinity in scheduling. And so the variants of cache affinity scheduling that we talked about are all excellent candidates to run on a multiprocessor. And in fact, the minimum intervention or minimum intervening scheduling policy and the minimum intervening scheduling with queuing, both of those are very good policies to use when you have a fairly light to medium load on the multiprocessor. Because that is the time when it is likely that a thread, when it is run on a processor, if it has a certain affinity for that particular processor, the contents of the cache are going to contain the memory contents for that particular thread. But on the other hand, if we have a very heavy load in the system, then it is likely that by the time a thread is run on a processor on which it is supposedly having an affinity, all of the cache may have been polluted because the load is very heavy. So in between the time that a thread got to run on a particular processor, next time it runs on the same processor, maybe its cache contents have been highly polluted by other threads. And therefore, if the load is very heavy, then maybe a fixed processor scheduling may work out to be much better than the variants of minimum intervening scheduling policies. So the moral of the story is that you really have to pay attention to both how heavily loaded your processor is or system is, and also what is the kind of workload that you are catering to. Both those things play a part in deciding what may be the best scheduling policy. And it may not always be the case that the same scheduling policy applies in all circumstances. So a real agile operating system may choose to vary the scheduling policy based on the load as well as the current set of threads that need to run on the system. Another interesting wrinkle to picking a scheduling policy is the idea of procrastination. And that is, normally we think of the scheduler when a processor is looking for work, it's going to the run queue and saying, well, I need to do something and let me pick the next thread to run on myself. That's what a processor is going to do. Perhaps procrastination may help. Why will procrastination help? First of all, how do we implement procrastination? Well, what the processor can do is, it is actually ready to do some work. Now, what it does is, it's going to insert an idle loop. Why will it insert an idle loop? It'll insert an idle loop because it's looking in the scheduling queue, and it sees that there is no thread in the scheduling queue that has run on it before. And therefore, if it schedules any one of those threads, though all of those threads are not going to find any of their working set in the cache of the processor. And therefore, the processor says, okay, now let me just spin my wheels for a while, not schedule anything. It is likely that a thread that has its cache content in that processor becomes runnable again. And then you can schedule that, and that might be a win in terms of performance. So in other words, procrastination may help boost performance. We saw this already in the synchronization algorithms when we talked about inserting delays in the scheduling algorithm in order to reduce the amount of contention on the interconnection network. That's the same sort of principle. Oftentimes, you'll see in system design, procrastination actually helps in boosting performance. It helps in the synchronization algorithms. It helps in scheduling. Later on, when we talk about file systems, you'll see that it helps in the design of file systems also.